This is the view from the International Space Station. It's pretty nice. For the astronauts living on the station, a view like this may be awe-inspiring, but it also emphasizes just how dangerous the return journey back to Earth really is. Since the space shuttle retired in 2011, the Russian Soyuz spacecraft has been the only method of transporting humans to and from the ISS. In 2012, SpaceX became the first private company to send a cargo ship to the ISS using their Dragon spacecraft. But when are SpaceX going to send their first humans to the International Space Station? In this video, we're going to look at SpaceX's Dragon 2 spacecraft, which aims to take humans to and from the International Space Station and beyond. We're also going to look at the problems SpaceX has had with Dragon 2, as well as taking a look at SpaceX's close competition with Boeing. Early on in SpaceX's history, the plan was to make a spacecraft called Dragon, which would be capable of delivering and returning cargo from the International Space Station. Once they achieved this, they would then focus on their human spacecraft, Dragon 2, which was designed to carry a crew of 7 people to the ISS and return them safely back to Earth. Dragon 2 was designed to launch on the Falcon 9 and Falcon Heavy rockets, dock with the ISS, and then return to Earth with a propulsive landing using 8 Super Draco engines mounted around the perimeter of the spacecraft. This would allow the Dragon 2 spacecraft to be fully reusable, as well as being able to perform controlled landings. After its unveiling in 2014, Dragon 2 went through a number of tests, starting with a pad abort test, which was successfully completed in May of 2015. The test showed how Dragon would carry astronauts to safety if an emergency occurred on the launch pad. Later that year, SpaceX also performed a propulsive hover test of the Dragon capsule to demonstrate how the vehicle could be controlled during a propulsive landing. Since then, the Dragon 2 spacecraft has gone through a number of changes, delaying its initial launch by over 2 years. SpaceX decided to scrap the propulsive landing idea, since it would take a lot of time and money to prove to NASA that it was safe for crewed flights. They also realized that spending more time and money on the Dragon spacecraft would take away from the progress being made on the BFR, which would be able to do everything that Dragon is capable of, and much more. Instead, the spacecraft will have a more familiar landing technique, deploying parachutes and splashing down in the ocean. Now that SpaceX has a clearer understanding of how Dragon 2 will work, the question is, when will it launch? And when will we eventually see humans launch on board a SpaceX rocket? The very first mission for the Dragon 2 capsule is scheduled to launch later this year in August. The mission will be an uncrewed test flight to demonstrate to NASA that the vehicle is capable of docking with the ISS and returning safely to Earth. If this first mission is a success, SpaceX will then attempt to launch a Dragon capsule with humans on board to the ISS in December of this year. But before either of those two missions can go ahead, SpaceX will have to perform an in-flight abort test, which is scheduled to take place later this year between the two demo flights. This test will use the Super Draco engines to pull the Dragon capsule away from the rocket as it goes through Max Q. In the race to launch American astronauts to the ISS, SpaceX has some competition. Boeing are looking to launch their crew capsule, the CST-100 Starliner, a month earlier than SpaceX in November. Both companies have already been awarded contracts by NASA to perform at least one mission to the ISS each year. When both companies eventually get their spacecraft off the ground, SpaceX will be the cheaper option for NASA. However, since they will only be doing around 2 flights per year, the Dragon spacecraft doesn't need to be rapidly reusable, which is another reason they gave up on the propulsive landing idea. So, while we eagerly wait for SpaceX to launch their first humans into space, we can appreciate how much work goes into making the spacecrafts that will take them there. And although Dragon 2 has taken a while to come to fruition, it does seem like we're finally on our way to seeing SpaceX launch their first humans into space. An important milestone in the overall journey to Mars. What do you think of the Dragon 2 spacecraft? Will it launch this year, or will we have to wait even longer to see its maiden voyage? If you enjoyed this video and would like to become one of our first contributors to Primal Space, please visit patreon.com/primalspace. And make sure you're subscribed so you can join the discussion as we continue to learn more about all things space. Thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.
Okay, Donya, where you have my hot mic?
How long we had that?